Hello everyone. This talk deals with the use of a nonlinear network analyzer, or NVNA, including not only two ports, as it is usually the case, but in a multi-port configuration. Due to the large number of ports, short-open-load-thru and short-open-load-reciprocal, or unknown-thru calibration, may be extremely time-consuming, as several through calibration steps are required. In this presentation, we will see how to perform a SOLT or SOLR calibration with a passive and then a reciprocal multiport through structure. The principle of a nonlinear VNA or NVNA is the use of a VNA not to measure wave ratio like reflection coefficient or S parameter, but to measure A and B waves. Typically, NVNA users have a two-port NVNA based on the use of four-port VNA. I have represented here a two-port NVNA system from Roger Schwartz VNA and a user-defined test set. Most nonlinear measurements can be performed with this configuration as long as the phase measurement of the harmonic frequencies relative to the fundamental one is not necessary. This configuration is low cost and it is also very easy to extend up to four ports. On the other hand, if you want the time-domain waveform of a multi-harmonic signal at the axis of a two-port device, the use of a four-port VNA with two independent sources is mandatory. Here, port 1 and 2 are associated with the RF source generating the dot signal. Port 3 and the second independent source are dedicated to the reference comp generator, or HPR, for harmonic phase reference. So you need a four-port VNA to create a two-port NVNA. There are two options to increase the number of ports on a NVNA. The simplest, but also the most expensive method, consists on using a VNA, including a large number of direct receiver channels. The other solution consists on building a switch matrix in order to create additional ports associated with a single port on the initial VNA. The need for a multiport NVNA is associated with the characterization and validation of new multiple input-output nonlinear RF circuits, such as digital duality or load-modulated balance amplifier. The multiport NVNA is also supported by the emergence of phase array antennas. It can make possible the behavioral modeling of beamformers requested by a large phase array antenna simulation. Now that a multiport NVNA has been presented, I will focus on its calibration. Traditionally, the calibration of a two-port NVNA is based on a relative calibration applied to each port of the NVNA. Thus, three error terms allow to correct the uncalibrated waves, A1M, B1M, for example, measured by an NVNA port in order to calculate the gamma in the reference plane, where waves A1 and B1 are illustrated. The second port is calibrated with a short open load as well to identify error terms beta 2, gamma 2, delta 2. To ensure correct transfer gain measurement, a transfer calibration is performed with a through standard depicted in green on this figure. This through calibration makes the port 2 calibration absolute and complete. This absolute calibration is consistent in magnitude and phase with port 1 calibration. To get an absolute calibration of port 1, we need two standards, one in magnitude and one in phase. This final absolute calibration leads us to the final error term, alpha 1. With a multiport NVNA, the calibration procedure remains the same. First of all, we have to calibrate each individual port in short open load. Then the through must be applied between every port. The approach right now and available in commercial VNAs consists on performing N-1 two-port calibration method between port 1 and each other port. This paper will present a theory and application on how to use a multi-port through in order to calibrate a NVNA with a large number of ports in one shot. Here's the outline of the presentation. First, I will remind you what is a one-port short-open-load calibration and how we get the three error terms per port on the NVNA. Then I will present the SOLT calibration method. With this method, we assume to know perfectly the S parameter of the through standard. Thus, by applying an error signal on port 1 only, we measure every port simultaneously, and it's possible to identify all transmission error terms on a multiport NVNA in one shot. After, we will present the SOLR calibration method using a multiport through circuit that is reciprocal. With this method, RF source is activated sequentially on every port of the NVNA. Thus, the number of measurements during the through calibration is far larger than the number of unknowns, so a sorting algorithm is performed to ensure good calibration accuracy. The two new multiport SOLT and SOLR will be compared to a conventional but more time-consuming SOLR method on a four-port VNA. This comparison will validate our calibration methods. Finally, I will present how to software-define a multiport NVNA with LabVIEW. And also, I will present the conversion formula between the NVNA error terms and the GSOLT multiport VNA 12 error terms model that is used in commercial VNA. Let's start with the one-port relative calibration of a VNA or NVNA. For this purpose, we measure three perfectly known gamma standard short open load and three uncalibrated measurements for those standard gamma M. And from these three measurements, we can solve the linear system leading us to the three error terms related to the measurement port number I. This short open load calibration leads us to a partially calibrated system. For example, by applying this incomplete calibration, our port 2 can measure properly gamma, but the gain between port 1 and port 2 won't be correct. In order to make every port of our system consistent in magnitude and phase with the measurement performed on port 1, we will proceed a through calibration, either SOLT if the through is totally known, or SOLR if the through is unknown. The through calibration will identify the value of the fourth error terms alpha I for the port number I. With the SOLT algorithm, in the two port, we assume that we already know the S2P of the through device used during the calibration. Here we assume that alpha 1 is equal to 1, and then A1 is equal to A1 bar. Then we can write easily the wave equality equation, that is B2 is equal to S21A1 plus S22A2. By substitution with partially calibrated data, I mean A bar and B bar, we can easily identify the value of alpha 2 to make the port 2 consistent with port 1. And we can generalize this equation to a multiport measurement system by writing it in a matrix form. Thus, SOLT forward calibration of a multiport NVNA can be performed in the following way. The signal is active on port 1 only, and the waves are measured on all ports. As we are in the SOLT method, the SNP calibration standard is assumed to be perfectly known. Obtaining the term alpha 2 up to alpha n is then given by the same equation as before, but generalized to multiport. Now that we have presented the SOLT method for NVNA in the two-port and in the multiport cases, we will now deal with the SOLR method. The SOLR method, which stands for Short Open Load Reciprocal, does not require the complete knowledge of the calibration standard through. It is just mandatory for this standard to be reciprocal, which is the case when the circuit is passive. This method has been proposed in 1992 by Andrea Ferro and his colleague Pisani on the two-port VNA. Here, we will not only deal with the SOLR calibration for NVNA formalism, but also to generalize it to multiport. The SOLR method assumes that the through multiport calibration device is reciprocal. In terms of S parameter, this means that Sij is equal to Sji. It is this assumption that will lead us to the identification of the error terms alpha 2 to alpha n, as we have done with the multiport SOLT method. The difference here is that the active source will change from port 1 to port 2 until the port n. For each active source position, all the waves A and B are measured. These waves A and B can be represented in matrix form with matrix A and matrix B, where the element Bij, for example, corresponds to the wave B measured on port I when the active source is on port J. From these matrices A and B, the S-parameter matrix of the device under test is given by the matrix B multiplied by the inverse of the matrix A. So, if the system were fully calibrated, we would have S is equal to B multiplied by A inversed. But we are dealing with a partially calibrated system where only short open load has been performed at each port. With such an incomplete calibration, we can measure S bar. And the relation between S and S bar is linear. Because we know by assumption that the standard device is reciprocal, we have one more equation, that is Sij is equal to Sji. This equation leads us to alpha j equal plus or minus alpha I, square root of the ratio of S bar measurement. There are two solutions. The correct solution is selected according to an estimation of argument of Sij. Practically, we will start from alpha 1 is equal to 1, and then we will calculate for every alpha I, for I equal to 2 to n. But there are a large number of measurements that make the identification of alpha I possible. That's why we will use a sorting algorithm that considers only the best measurement to calculate the error terms. This method is the Dijkstra algorithm. And I'm going to show you how it works with an example on non-ideal 4-port true calibration standard. This standard is a 10 dB coupler, which has been unbalanced by adding a 3 dB attenuator on one of the coupled ports. This device has a strong isolation between port 1 and port 4, as well as between 2 and 3. It is therefore not ideal, and it is hard to imagine to calibrate an NVNA with the multiport SOLT method with such a S41. During the SOLR calibration, all the measurement configurations are measured. Then, only the largest value of Sij bar of interest are considered for the calculation of alpha. So, we start from port 1 with alpha 1 is equal to 1. From this port 1, we have three possible RF paths going respectively to port 2, 3 and 4. The path presenting the minimal losses is the path connecting port 1 and port 2 in this example. This RF path is therefore selected. The measurement S12 bar and S21 bar are used to calculate alpha 2. So now we have two known nodes in our diagram, 1 and 2. Starting from known nodes, 1 and 2 in red, and going toward unknown nodes, 3 and 4, four RF paths are possible. The path presenting the minimal losses is, in this case, joining port 1 and port 3, and correspond to 10 dB of attenuation. The RF path is then selected. S13 bar and S31 bar are considered to calculate alpha 3. Now the node number 3 is known. It remains to identify the missing nodes starting from one of the three known nodes. The RF path presenting the minimal losses consists in starting from number 3 to go toward 4 in this example. Alpha 4 is identified from measurement S34 bar and S43 bar. The diagram is complete. All error terms related to the through calibration are identified. This concludes the multiport through calibration of our NVNA. So now we just have to test our SOLT, our SOLR multiport algorithm. For this, we will compare 4-port measurement of S parameter made with a commercially available multiport calibration, the classic SOLR, and some measurement, the same measurement made with the new calibration proposed here. The classic SOLR calibration of the through is carried out with three steps, with a direct transition illustrated here with device A. A multiport SOLT and SOLR calibration will be tested with a T standard presenting few losses, this is the standard B, and a non-ideal standard presenting high isolation, the standard C. For this purpose, we measure device B and C as S4P from an NVNA calibrated in SOLR with standard A and NVNA calibrated both in SOLT and in SOLR with standard B and C. The comparison of S parameter helps us to conclude on our new SOLT and SOLR method. First, if your multiport through standard does not have a lot of losses, like our standard B, SOLT and SOLR method show very similar results. SOLT is very fast. There is only one forward measurement during calibration, but require an accurate S parameter of the standard. But if your standard presents some losses or high isolation, like our standard C between port 1 and 4, the SOLR method is pretty robust, because the less lossy RF path will be selected with our algorithm in order to calculate the alpha error terms. But the SOLT with a lossy standard destroys the consistency of the measurement even if the S-parameters of the standard are known. This slide presents the architecture of the multiport NVNA as implemented in LabVIEW. First, a port object includes its own CalKit and RF switch matrix configuration. It enables easy measurement of hybrid devices. At the end, the multiport NVNA is an array of those predefined ports. The user has to calibrate each port in short open load. Then it is possible to calibrate in through the complete system. The user will have to consider a SNP file that contains S parameter of the standard in SOLT or an estimation of the phase transfer for the SOLR. The number of ports is therefore unlimited. This slide offers the equations to convert NVNA calibration error term to conventional GSOLT 12 error terms model. It will be pretty useful if you want to import these new calibration error terms in your native VNA error term tables. Now it's time to conclude. First, about the new multiport SOLT and SOLR method algorithm and validation have been presented. Notice that SOLT and SOLR method are less time consuming than procedure embedded with commercial VNA right now. For the very first time, conversion between multiport NVNA error terms and multiport VNA have been presented. And I offered a glimpse on how to manage a multiport NVNA in LabVIEW, for example. These calibration methods for multiport NVNA are prime of importance for MIMO system as a dual input power amplifier, beamformer dice, or large signal phased array antenna measurement. Thank you for your attention.
All the leaves are brown and the sky is gray. I went for a walk on a winter's day. I'd be safe and warm if I was in LA. California dreaming on such a winter's day.